Hi everyone, I'm Ekta Jaju and I'm with Organic Foods. Organic farming is literally free of cost apart from the cost of labor. So a farmer grows indigenous varieties of seeds which he can save and doesn't have to buy expensive seeds year on year. He can make his own inputs. So input is a big challenge with farmers. Over the last couple of decades, it's been seen that every year the farmer has to increase the amount of input that his land requires, but relatively, the output from his land is not increasing proportionately. Also, the price of the input has grown tremendously over the years. So it's just not making sense. And these inputs are really literally killing the land. So crops survive on the health of the soil. And it's the microbes and the earthworms that actually build that. And chemical fertilizers just kill it. It completely destroys farmers' land. So using chemical fertilizer just does not make sense. And also pesticides. So when we look at the Green Revolution or using the chemicals to grow food, we're looking at growing hybrid varieties which are extremely sensitive to water requirements, to climate vagaries. And compared to that, an indigenous organic crop is extremely, extremely sturdy, is pest resilient, climate resilient. So when we started to work with farmer and the small farmer community, we realized that one of the biggest challenges that small organic farmers face in the country is lack of reliable supply chain. There aren't enough people who are looking at buying organic indigenous varieties of produce or pay a high premium for it. And if a farmer can't sell what he was growing, he will not have money to grow for the next season. He will not be able to feed his family. So if he can't sell, he will not grow. The challenges for the agrarian community is even worse. Out of the three crops in the year, we've seen climate impacts on at least two of the crops, and rice was a major crop last year which got severely affected because of the rainfall patterns which did not happen like they were supposed to. A lot of what we've done to mitigate climate change, a lot of what we've done to adapt to climate change is clearly not enough. It's clearly not adequate. Things are going from bad to worse. And I think we really need some drastic step. It's a terrible time for farmers. And it's also terrible for the food security of the country. We could look at agroforestry. We could look at planting more trees. We could look at planting more forests. We could look at restoring forests. Sundarban has lost so many of its mangrove forests. We should be looking at rebuilding that. We should be looking at carbon sinks across the country. There's so much that we can do. Also, we should be looking at ways to cut down on our carbon. I think we still have the time to make the right choices, to make that shift. And let's grab on to that opportunity and hope that we as a society are able to make these choices and change the way things are.